Each year in the primary school, we commemorate Anzac Day at the start of Term 2. We take this time to remember those who have served in the past and those who continue to serve into the future. Many of you will have family members or family friends who have served in the Air Force, Army or Navy, making this a very special and personal time of remembrance. Some of your parents may even be on active duty as we speak. For others, you may simply be thankful for the sacrifice made on your behalf to protect our freedoms. Whatever your situation, today at SCBC, we will remember them.
Today's Bible verse is from John 15, verses 12 to 14. These are Jesus' words. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command.
Let's pray together. Dear Father, we thank you for the sacrifice of our servicemen and women. And because of their sacrifice, Father, we thank you so much for the freedom that we get to enjoy in Australia. And finally, we thank you so much for your wonderful sacrifice, for the love that you have shown for us by dying on the cross. We also pray, Lord, for the protection for those that are on duty, especially for our parents who are traveling or serving in the Defence Forces. We also pray for our perseverance and our strength and comfort for our students and parents who are part of our school community. For these things we ask in your wonderful name. Amen.
Good morning, families and students. My name is Nikki Campbell. I am the Defence School Mentor at South Coast Baptist College. I feel very privileged to be able to speak to you this morning, for me, it is a great honour to be able to support the 60 Defence students we have here from the Navy families. I know from personal experience it can be challenging to be a Defence spouse, having long periods of separation from your partner, while supporting them in their role and looking after family needs. Moving from one location to another, integrating into a new community, having a young family, helping them transition in and out of a new school, connecting with other families and making new friends brings challenging times. I am dedicated to supporting these students with the challenges they face being separated from their family members. For example, assuring them that they are not alone, building up their confidence, helping them deal with their emotions, encouraging friendships by connecting them with others. Also, I'm here to provide assistance to the parents of Defence students as a point of contact, providing information from the Defence Community Organisation and helping integrate new families into the community. Anzac Day gives us the chance to stand up and honour our servicemen and women, past and present, who have fought for our freedom, made sacrifices being away from families and friends, putting themselves into dangerous situations so that we can all live in this amazing country we call home, Australia. Have a wonderful day.
May I now introduce to you Lynette Emery. Lynette is a Navy chaplain based here at Garden Island. Lynette will share an address with us now in regards to Anzac Day and what that means for us.
Good morning, and thank you for welcoming me to your school. It's my great honour this morning to bring you this Anzac Day address. I'm a Navy chaplain, and I'm a mum, and my kids are a little bit older than you. In my life, I've missed very few Anzac Day ceremonies, and my personal connection to Anzac Day is one of the reasons I have chosen to serve Australia with great pride as a chaplain. And I believe it's also a great privilege. In Australia and New Zealand, Anzac Day is a tradition of honour, not just to remember the battles of the past, but because it's also a day that unites us as a nation and also unites our two countries. Its significance is powerful because no matter what is happening, it continues to bring us together. Anzac Day has become the inheritance for us of all those who fought that we would be free. It is traditional on Anzac Day to hear something about battle, to hear about personal experiences of war and of military service, and to hear about death and sacrifice. And I have no doubt you will have heard stories about that kind of fierce sacrifice. In Australia and New Zealand, we make a big deal about this sacrifice. And there's a reason that we spend so much energy reminding ourselves of something that happened over 100 years ago. Their sacrifice has become our heritage, and it reminds us of who we are and of what we represent. And I think it brings us a challenge. Remembering gives us purpose. It reminds us that we have a future and a solid foundation. Students, teachers, parents, our future is built on the foundations and the actions of those who fought for us. Today is a day that we remember that others fought for us and willingly gave their lives to protect us. They gave willingly to bring honour, to defend the lives of people they didn't even know, you and me. They gave their very best service for us. They were light horsemen. They were nurses, doctors, sailors and engineers, combat specialists and soldiers, submariners and many more. They were young men and women not that much different from us. And they served and they died for us so that we could be born and live in freedom and in hope. So now it's our turn to make it count for our kids and for our grandkids. Their sacrifice brought us a reputation among the nations. They showed the world that Australians and New Zealanders have a fierce determination, fierce dedication, and great courage, and that we don't give up without a fight. So it's up to us to take part in their inheritance, to be determined and to be courageous. So I ask you, what will you do to continue that honour? How will you be inspired by them to live, to serve each other, and to have hope for our future? We should continue what they began, to live each day with courage and honour, to not be afraid to defend the weak, to stand up for others, or to act with kindness, to speak words of gentleness, and to give generously, and to live in thankfulness. That is our inheritance. You are the next generation of Australian leaders, so you walk in the footsteps of the Anzacs. So what does that look like for you? Well, it is my hope and my fervent prayer that you and I would work together as a nation that gives honour, lives with courage, and looks to the future, and will continue to allow the pride of our Anzacs and all who have served our nation and those who continue to serve to inspire us with honour and courage. I pray that your future will be full of generous service to your nation in whatever you choose to pursue, and that you will be inspired to live and to work for hope and for unity, lest we forget.
Please stand up wherever you are as I read the ode. After I have read the ode, please stay standing for a moment of silence, being thankful in your heart and your mind for service of others. The ode comes from For the Fallen, a poem by English poet and writer Lawrence Binyon, 1914. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them, lest we forget.